5:03 p.m. I'd like to convene the April 19th meeting of the San Lorenzo Valley Water District Board of Directors. Can we have a roll call?
So, do a roll call real quick, I guess, if you want. Want to do it?
Sure.
So, we have Chair Bachman.
Here.
Director Ratcliffe is absent. Director Smallman is absent. Director Hammer is absent. Director Bruce just entered the door. So, we have 2 of 5 directors here tonight. I believe, and I will check the council, that 2 of 5 does not constitute a quorum, which means we will not be able to have closed session tonight. Absent closed session, I believe that we would need to adjourn this meeting to open session, which will occur at 6:30.
We recommend adjourning the meeting until the start of open session at 6:30 p.m.
I will do so. At 5:04 p.m., the open session portion before closed session of the April 19th meeting of the San Lorenzo Valley Water District Board of Directors is adjourned until open session at 6:30 p.m.
Excellent.
All right. I'm going to
Like I said, I mean, when we first started thinking about this, we're not employees, and that's the big thing. But obviously, this board wants to interpret this law, because as they did for Vieira, as an employee. And you know what? As a director, I think this communication to the public is in our scope of work, actually, if you think about it. Of course, allegedly, confidential, but it's alleged confidential information. So, but I think it's actually part of our scope, actually, to communicate to you. What else are we going to do, actually? To communicate to the newspaper who distributes that information. So I would arguably say that it is in our scope of work. And you're going to tell me that selling real estate as a real estate agent, violating one of the most basic ethics law on the books is part of the scope. So, you know, and like I said, there was no time limit on this. You know, I researched it, and I'm going through it, and I got to the point of getting threats to say, hey, you got to sign this thing. And, I'm not going to sign it just, right off the bat. I'm just not going to do that. And it's just, can we all get along? this is just really a ridiculous thing that we're going through here. And, you've been called a leaker. So people say, oh, you're a leaker. You leaked and you caused all this damage to the water district. Well, please tell me what the damage is. Please tell me what the real damage is we're focused on this, and we're not focused on putting pipes in the ground. That's the real damage.
Okay. Any other comment? I have none.
I think the real damage is a deeper one. Yeah, we're spending a lot of frivolous time on this bill because there's a breach of trust and a breach of the law. And this is an issue of principle with me. It's not about the Terry Vieira case. It's not about whatever happened in that particular closed session. It was the incredibly cavalier nature of your attitude that whatever was said in that confidential space, in that private space, could be easily telegraphed to a member of the media when you didn't happen to agree with the advice of a lawyer, or with the words of your colleagues, or with the words of staff. If you don't happen to agree on something else, what's the next thing you're going to run to your friends and to your social media site and to the media with? Can we trust you to bite your tongue as we do? Oh, really? When we are in closed session, we don't always agree. And we keep our peace and we keep our confidentiality. Will you ever be able to do that? Is that enough?
Before we move on, I want to ask you just one basic question. Are you... no, I don't. Okay. I am frustrated by the process. I'm disappointed that you told us 2 months ago that you would go down a direction, and I heard a lot of you saying that you aren't. I don't know that you said that exactly, and I don't really want to ask you that in this meeting, because I don't want to put you into the position that you need to make a commitment one way or the other. But I am disappointed that we spent 2 months working with you and trying to get you to work with us to come to something that you agreed that you would do. So at this point, there's no action that needs to be taken on this, and I think it's just time to close out this item for the evening and move on. So let's move on to unfinished business. Item 10A, engineering and design services contract negotiations.
So I was going to hold this until staff updates, but I think this is an appropriate time to hand this out given the comments of the last item. From the public specifically. This is a snapshot of something that we're working on for the budget this year. And anyone who's interested, I've only got a few left. I will pass them out and we will have to share them. This is a list of capital facilities projects, replacement projects that the district has scheduled to have in some form or another process over the next 2 years. At the end of 2 years from tonight, at the end of 2 years from the budget approval for next year, all of these projects are going to be in some form or situation of creation. Many of them are going to be completed, many of them are going to be in pre-design, many of them are going to be fully in design, and some of them are even going to be in bidding process. $15 million. $15 million in a 2 year time period. This district is going to move to do pipes, pumps, and tanks. I'm happy for the applause out there, the recognition that this board, the majority of this board, has actually moved and done what they promised to do, the focus on pipes, pumps, and tanks. I'm thankful for that recognition. I want to thank this board majority for doing that. You guys have gone through a hell of a lot over the last 3 years. And that's what you're finally at. You're at this point, $15 million in 2 years time period. We're going to be moving forward on. That's a great thing to be doing. I'm very proud of you for that. Now, to that end, we're moving forward on the USDA projects, which are on this list, approximately $5 million worth. And we went through an RFQ process. We received a number of qualification packages from a number of engineering firms, and those projects' qualification packages were reviewed and ranked. The top three firms I'm recommending tonight that you authorize me or allow me to go negotiate price and term for a time and material not to exceed contract, which I will bring back to you at a later date for all three firms. Those firms are MME, formerly Messini Miller Engineering, Schaff and Wheeler, and Freitas and Freitas. They were ranked by the senior staff members of this district, and they were ranked by the chair of the board. And the rankings came back pretty similar. Pretty happy about that. The rankings are included in the board pack. So tonight I'm hoping the board can authorize me to go negotiate time and material not to exceed contracts so we can start moving on what the board majority has been working on for the past 3 years and getting facilities replaced. Because with the rate increase that went through last fall, because of all your hard effort, we now actually have the funding available to start doing these projects. And this is the next step in that process.
Okay.
As usual, would any of the board want to make a comment or two before I go to the public?
Good job. This is great. I noticed that a lot of people here are being good, got put on the list. And so, this is really moving forward. And I'm impressed. So, I want to make a motion to approve this.
Okay. We have a motion. A second. Okay. Let's take public comment. We'll have discussion after it returns. Any public comment on that?
Yeah, please move forward.
Mr. Fazolas.
Hey, you guys. This is really great. I know you can't hear the applause, but my mind is just screaming delight. All these years and all this work is finally starting to come together. And I would just encourage you, and I know Brian, you've got to be tired. Let's keep this list moving. So that in 2 years when this is done, there's 2 more years right ahead of us. I know that that's what we're here for. I really appreciate this. This is really going to make a big difference in our valley. For 40 or 50 years. Thanks.
Okay, thank you. Other public comment? Mr. Lee.
I just have some more technical questions here during finance. I'm Mark Clay from that moment. Being an MBA in finance and used to be a financial analyst as well as a farmer planner. I'm kind of concerned that these numbers are coming, this is addressing President Laughlin. These numbers are coming out of the Finance Committee, correct?
No. These are, Finance Committee does not have the technical expertise to be determining engineering costs.
So has there been discussion through the committee framework to approve these various scopes of work and projected?
No, this is not a Budget and Finance Committee appropriate subject.
So where has it been transmitted to the public for discussion?
It's being transmitted this evening. These are items that have been in the capital improvements. Go ahead with your question. I'd rather take all public input and then let it come back to staff for explanation.
The second question is, where are the revenues to cover? What's the ratio of revenues to cover this in 2 years? That's the second question, and so I'd like to have those answered by
quickly.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Any other public comment? Okay, Ms. Lavallo.
Quick question. I guess it's assuming that this is also done the same way the county does a lot of their approvals of businesses to do the work. They'd be checking their performance bonds and all their other items like that. Bonds, and they do the I can't even remember all the other names, and that all gets taken care of. Will be able to do the job, and there's money put aside so that they can, if something fails, that they'll be able to cover the expenses if they mess up and things like that. That's exciting because the longer you wait for doing any of these projects, the more it gets expensive. So that's kind of neat that it's going to move forward. So I'm excited about it too. So.
Okay. Other public input? I don't see any hands up. Let me come back to the board and go to staff.
So just a couple of responses to the public comments. All of these projects with exception, these projects have been discussed at various committee levels or board meetings. The Lompico projects have been discussed, the USDA projects have been discussed, the FEMA projects have been discussed, the planning projects we've discussed. The PAYGO projects, we've discussed most of them. Some of them the staff has been withholding until we actually get to a point where we have enough information to bring to you. But the majority of the PAYGO projects we've also discussed as well. All of these projects should not come as a shock to anybody who has been paying attention. That's important. Regarding financing, We're not going to do all these pay-as-you-go, obviously. That's not going to happen. And we are going to have to borrow money to do most of these projects in the two-year time period, or three-year time period that we're proposing. 2 years to get them going, 3 years to hopefully complete them all. The rate increase gives us the mechanism to borrow money using the rate increase as leverage to guarantee that we can pay these projects, which will allow us to borrow the money to move these projects. I think I said, at least in one prior occasion, we're trying to kickstart the CIP program. So we're going to borrow money to kickstart this program. That's what this represents. For those of you who have questions regarding construction contracts in particular, I would recommend that you go to our website and download our bidding document and take a look at it. It is very comprehensive. It is very detailed. Performance and labor bonds and things along that nature are all laid out in there. If you have a mind of that nature, you'll love it. If you don't, you'll fall asleep in 3 minutes. So it's all laid out in there. You'll get to see exactly what this district, how this district is proposing it completes its contracts. The probation tank contract is actually out there right now, which, by the way, we're opening bids on Tuesday. Fingers crossed we get good bids.
Okay. I count 11 projects here in the board packet, or maybe they're double. Okay. Yes. Thirteen, perhaps. I mean, this is a much larger list of projects than is in the board packet. This is a huge ramp up in how the district has gone in the past. We have much. We have a revenue source that we didn't have before. This is a wonderful thing to be looking at. I get a little bit nervous in the ramp-up rate, and I just want to think through these things in a kind of calm manner. One of the things that I'm interested in is having perhaps a broad support from senior staff on this matter, and I want to get to that in some manner that is does not take a great deal of time, and but is a place that I can get comfortable with a very dramatic, a step function in our activities. So before I go to staff to see if there are any comments, I don't know.
I had not to be in any way a wet blanket on the enthusiasm and ambition of what we've been working at all this time to get to. I look at this and I think about how much work is involved, how much work for Jen for permitting, how much work for Stephanie for all of the invoicing and the contracts, and for legal for the same, and for especially the operations team. How incredibly huge this is. Two-part question. Is there an envisioned staff augmentation to help address this? And I know we have a headcount set aside in the future budget, but what is your team plan for addressing what is looking to me like a very, very stacked Gantt chart that's got lots and lots of moving pieces, and only a few of you who are already spread really thin to work on this? I'd love to know how we're going to eat this elephant in so few bites. That's my one caution, is that yes, we're going to do this. Yes, I'm enthusiastic, and I don't want to kill you guys.
We do have plans. We did a staffing study as part of the cost of service study. The staffing study recognized the need for a project manager position. We are going to be requesting that project manager position in the upcoming budget discussion. That person will be able to manage the contracts that we will be letting for design services and then with the engineers and also with the contractors as the contracts are awarded for construction. That individual will be able to take the lion's share of the coordination, shall we say. We are still going to require environmental work for permits. We are still going to require operations work for identifying facilities and getting the best product that we can, the best value for our money. We're going to have financial burdens, obviously, if we manage all of these contracts through. We are going to be hiring, I think, close to $2 million worth of consultants initially to get these projects rolling. But absent the consultants, absent the project manager, absent committing the dollars to get this to happen, it's not going to happen. So staff is nervous. I've had frank conversations with all senior staff, and I think if they were going to be honest, they would be very hesitant to give their full enthusiastic support moving forward with this, because this district, I don't believe, has ever done such an aggressive program. But we have FEMA projects. We have to repair it. Right. We have PAYGO projects that are a cause of the conditions. Well repairs and well constructions due to failing wells. We have the Bear Creek wastewater system. We have to come up with a solution for that. So that's built in here. The USDA projects, primarily pipeline projects, from an environmental standpoint, knock on wood, low lift, linear projects and streets, we should be able to get that taken care of. And then we have the Long Depot projects. We have a commitment to get those projects done within 10 years. So.
Yeah, sure, sure.
I would just suggest from a process and human resources point of view that there be a way to do a regular check-in to make sure that there's, you know, we have to be banging on all four cylinders or six cylinders, or every senior staff you've got, and if there's somebody who's getting tired, overburdened, becomes a bottleneck because of other responsibilities, or, let's get a point in here, but that there be a clear channel both between senior staff and from you to the board to make sure that we are acting in our capacity to ensure that you have the resources and support to succeed.
And I'm hoping to continue to have frank conversations with senior staff regarding that. They've been hopefully, I suspect they've been holding their funding, but they've been honest with me. They've been brutally honest, but they've been honest with me. So I'm not going into this blindly. Despite accusations aside, I was hired for pipes, pumps, and tanks, and that's what we're doing. It's taken us a long time to get here, and I don't want to stop now.
Any senior staff input? No pressure? Okay.
I can say, yeah, that's an incredible listen. I don't want to set us up to fail. I think we're biting off on making sure. I've told Brian that there's too much work here. We have a system around, an old system around that has a lot going on daily. It's an incredible lift for senior staff. And a lot of this is going to take historical knowledge of the system. A lot of it goes on me. And I'm not going to be here that much longer. I'm on my downhill. Incredible. I don't want to see us enter into a contract with consultants and not be able to hold up our end and wind up, you know, with egg on our face and paying out money because we can't get the work done, paying consultants to stand around and try to get work done and don't have the senior staff. All of this is going to take incredible senior staff. Brian's very enthusiastic. I just don't think we can deal with it. We can get a lot of it done, and I don't want to pull back, but I don't want to overcommit.
What would you modify? How would you modify it? What would you do differently?
Well, I mean, we haven't talked about prior, you know, to really prioritize. You know, it's been one main list, get it all done. And we haven't sat as senior staff, as a group, the district manager, and had that conversation. At least I haven't. I mean, I don't know the rest of you.
We prioritize the USDA projects. That list is based on priorities. The Long Depot projects are also a priority. The PAYGO projects are a priority. Most Some of them you can scale back on. And then the design, the last remaining one, the FEMA project, priority. Again, I agree fully with Rick. The priorities, you know, this is our priority list.
10 number one priorities.
So,
money's going to become an issue.
And then you are thinking about having a project manager.
He's going to, project manager is going to be a gentleman most likely that has never worked a day in the San Lorenzo Valley.
Well, yeah, so I mean. And
all of these projects have interface in our existing system,
yeah,
which has a ripple effect, but the existing system has to have analysis of the impact of these projects. We want to clean up a lot of our low pressure messes or a lot of our fire flow messes in the existing system. And that's what's going to take time to integrate, make sure when we do this, we do it once and we do it right. We clean up these projects as we go through these zones and areas and do the improvements that we need. Don't just go out and put in. Bear Creek Road's a great example. They went out and put a whole brand new pipe in Bear Creek Road 30, 40 years ago. They didn't do any changeover of the existing. So we were operating two systems. The old system started leaking. And we had to go back out there in district staff and literally change over all the services, all the laterals, all the side streets because it wasn't done properly when they did it the first time. They put a new main in. It was great. It worked great. But the old system was still in operation. And that's, we've got to take these step by step and do modeling of the system. The system hasn't been modeled.
Right.
So, yeah, you can use Rick Rogers saying, yeah, we need an 8-inch main. That's just more fuel my operations. But let's run it engineering wise and get some data that says we need to manage. There's a lot of work to be done in the existing system to bring in the new stuff. I don't want to miss an opportunity.
I think one of the big problems though too is what I've seen is if the design's faulty, if there's issues there, and then if you don't have some guy that can spot those and make sure that all of the very issues are taken care of and then are monitored. Monitor would just be over, but with this size or number of projects,
we want to work with the consultants and tell them our problems, work in the field with the consultants, so we engineer these problems out and the new construction begin. We clean up a lot of messes and get rid of a lot of the leaking pipe instead of leaving them around.
Okay, I believe Director Roberts would like this.
Quick recommendation, and I don't know if this is something that needs to be officially motioned and seconded, but I want to suggest that we set up an ad hoc committee that's a member of the board, President Bachman, and one other. I would volunteer just because I have a spring-loaded arm, right, and I like project management stuff. Together with senior staff to ensure that those kinds of constraints and limitations are integrated into this aggressive plan so that we've identified where the constraints and limitations are and how we can address whatever financial limitations there might be, technical, operational, and logistic problems there might be so that we speed the way to success. I want to make sure that there are the appropriate channels of communication to the engineering committee and to, between and among senior staff, and again the board through an ad hoc committee is given ample opportunity to ensure that we are aware of what resources are necessary. I want all of that to happen. I just don't want to compromise our system. I don't want to compromise our relationships with our regulatory agencies, nor do I want to end us up in a financial muddle when a little bit of, okay, so what's plan B, conversations could have prevented those things.
I'm inclined to go a little bit slower on this. I love the idea of moving on this. It's been a long time coming, and I'm eager to, I'm pleased that we have funding mechanisms to do something of this size. But I want to have everybody on board, including me, okay? And I'm not a civil engineer, and I feel like for me to get fully on board with this, I need to know more about it. So I'd like to have some time with everybody, all senior, okay, district manager and all senior staff if possible,
I like your idea of an ad hoc committee. And hopefully in a, you know, it doesn't need to be in existence terribly long. A couple of meetings, maybe a month, okay, in duration. That would give me the confidence that this is doable, or at least there's a path to getting to doable with this, and hear any alternative opinions or thoughts on this matter. So I would, okay, if you, would that as a motion?
Is it necessary?
It should be done by motion to
set up a committee.
Okay. I would like to move that we set up an ad hoc committee that addresses the questions about staff resource adequacy, financial adequacy, integration of all of the senior staff responsibilities with this aggressive project schedule to ensure that work with the selected consultants goes smoothly, that operations are not disrupted, that finance is not disrupted, and the communications with the board are done smoothly.
Okay.
I think the motion should include with the bodies the ad hoc committee and whether it takes time for him to be done for any case of business. Two board members, and senior staff.
For a period of, at maximum 2 months.
At maximum 2 months.
That would be agreeable to me. And then, since we haven't formally, I haven't been on the board at the time that the ad hoc committee was established. Do we need to establish the membership of that? The director? I'm thinking seniors.
That's going to have to be another. I mean, I suppose the board's identifying the reason we're here to do that.
Okay. I think as board president, I'm not a civil engineer, but I'm technical enough and mathematical enough. And I'm the board president. I think that's appropriate. I would suggest that you be on this. You brought this motion. You feel some enthusiasm for it.
Process princess.
Right, and I think it would be good to have a non-techie person perhaps on there.
And I do recommend taking...
Well, you are techie, but environment.
Because it's a little outside. Is it within the agenda item that we're discussing sufficiently so that, or do we need to agendize it for a future meeting?
It would be most appropriate to agendize it for a future meeting.
Okay. I think there's a possibility that we might want to agendize a special meeting to deal with some things that have been very difficult to get to, okay, in the past. I think it might be in a couple of weeks possible to do that. Could we work together to get a time to bring that? And then we probably have a fuller participation by the directors at that time. Okay.
So then we would go back to the original motion, and this gets put forward to another agenda for
special meeting under review requested.
Yes.
And with some
other items. Okay, that we've been, anyway, but that can be determined. Okay, we'll have a special meeting with an agenda that includes this. No need to specify the full agenda of a special meeting at this time. It can be suggested by any person, and by the board president. Haven't done that. Or should we have a special meeting for this topic only, since we're setting a time frame?
I think the only action that's appropriate in this time in the context of this agenda item is to refer
this item.
Item involving establishing an ad hoc committee to a subsequent special meeting agenda, and that other, yeah, to be determined, the date and time, and what other matters may or may not be discussed on that to be determined by staff for our decision.
Okay. Now we can turn our attention back to the motion that Director Smallman made, and then I seconded.
Okay. Could you restate that motion then?
Well, it's just basically to approve.
Well, would you? I mean, we're talking about having an ad hoc committee. Is
no,
there
no,
any?
No, 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 no. We're not talking about having an ad hoc committee.
No,
we're talking about approving the three.
Approving the services contract.
Oh.
For the three
multi.
Okay.
Services contract.
And we wandered down the road of how
okay.
We need that elephant and that device.
Well, okay. Yes. Do the two? Does the mover of that and the seconder of that still want to approve those
yes.
firms?
Yes.
Okay. I prefer that the ad hoc committee okay consider whether the, any of this process should be okay. This is the process for doing that.
I disagree. This process, the process of ranking and responding to the RFQ. It's
okay.
a separate issue from that of we're going to be undertaking these projects. How are we going to accomplish that in the most effective, most efficient manner possible? These are the resources that staff has identified as being appropriate to the task. They scored the highest in the review of their submittals. And these are the resources that staff is recommending to help them accomplish this set of tasks. We have a separate
I think the ad hoc committee could tweak or, you know, changes. Might seem a bit, but...
Like which company has which assortment, but my thought is
the
ad hoc committee, the purpose of it is to ensure that senior staff and are equipped and are addressing those bottlenecks in operations, finance, regulatory compliance and otherwise that would impede the progress of this list.
Okay. I don't think I'm ready for this yet. So I'd like I want a full discussion with senior staff before the structure of perhaps the ad hoc committee could deal with this. Okay, as one of okay, as part with whether we you know whether it's three firms, whether it's on time and materials or negotiated. I want to be able to have I want to feel confident that all voices in this process, especially senior staff, have been heard thoroughly, and that I understand what other people think about this before I am comfortable with it. So, I welcome any staff comment at any point in this, but I think it would be better to let, to have this at the ad hoc committee. We'll address that in a fairly short time frame, I hope.
Are there any? I'm going to have a question on staff. Sorry.
Sure, absolutely.
We've received responses to the RFQs. Did those responses to RFQs have any time limitation about the freshness date of their proposal? In other words, if we are going to take a few weeks to chew this over a little bit and mull this, is that going to impact the nature in any way of the responses that we've received?
No, but it's going to impact our ability to get the USDA loan. USDA loans are your processes to apply to them.
Okay. Is there a deadline there that we need to be aware of?
There is not necessarily a deadline to apply, but they award certain times of the year. And October 1st is the beginning of the year, so if we are working with USDA, we want to make sure the application package is submitted late summer. Delaying this process,
let's get this thing, let's get this meeting set up, okay, for a special meeting to address this. There's three directors that we need to work with, at least Director Ratcliffe, who should be here. But I think her availability is probably generally good. I'm not ready. Okay. So, I mean, I could call for a vote. I mean, would anybody, okay, do you want me to call for a vote?
Sure.
Okay. Okay. Chelsea?
Director Bruce?
Aye.
Director Smallman?
Well, I guess it...
You made the motion.
I know. But, I mean, it's okay. If you want to table it, I'm kind of confused, but maybe I should just... I'm okay with that. I mean, because I'm going to vote the way that I think we should... I'm comfortable to say I'm going to vote aye. Aye.
Chair Baldwin?
No.
I didn't want to squash her. Can't believe it.
Okay. I hope we can get this done, resolved in a quick manner.
Because I think, like I said before, I think the committee make any clues or whatever necessary.
Okay. Let's move on to the next agenda item. Award a bid for district-wide two-way radio system. Any staff? Okay.
We received two bids for the two-way radio system. One of the bids was non-responsive. It did not include taxes, delivery, and that, even though it was a low bid, it did not include all of the responses up front. So staff is recommending an award to Golden State Communications for $60,801 for replacing our two-way radios.
That looks like a reasonable price.
Yes.
Yeah. I'd make a motion to.
A second.
Okay. Public input. Item 10B. I don't see any input. What is that public? Mark.
Quick question. Where is the radio station going to be located?
Location, if I understand your question, it's a repeater system. One repeater is located at a high tank elevation in Boulder Creek, and the second repeater is located on a high tank location in Scotts Valley. The two repeaters will, the vehicle radios will talk to the repeaters, and then via the internet will send the signal to the repeater that's the closest.
Okay.
It also has, if the internet is down, it has talk around features.
Okay. Okay. Any other public comment? Okay, now I don't see any. Close that out. Pardon?
Not yet.
Okay, so we're back. There was a motion and a second. Any other discussion?
Director Bruce?
Yes.
Director Smallman?
Yes.
Chair Baldwin?
Yes. Okay. Let's move on to our hopefully awake public member who will, okay, to an item that are, okay, can still address this. So it's award of bid for conjunctive use fish consultant. So staff first.
Jen
first.
We put an RFP out for a fish consultant to look at our conjunctive use plan that we're developing with the conjunctive use grant. We received two
proposals, and I was one of the people that reviewed the proposals, as well as the county staff that is partnering with us on the conjunctive use plan program. And we have selected Mike Podleck to be awarded the contract for, don't have it in front of me, is it 47,000?
42,940.
42,940.
So this is all part of that, the conjunctive use.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
Okay.
He will be helping us to negotiate if any possible water rights changes. He'll help us to negotiate any permits that may come up with the CEQA for the pipeline changes and other kinds of things that have to do with fish impacts, possible impacts to fish for conjunctive use. So he'll help us navigate through all that.
Okay. Public on this? I don't see a comment from the public, other than any thoughts on. Okay. Thank you. Pardon?
No.
Not on this?
I'm here to answer any questions as they come up, so I need to say anything.
Oh, okay.
I'll make a motion to approve 42,000 to Mr.
Public. And
second.
Okay. Would you call a vote?
Director Bruce?
Yes.
Director Smallman?
Yes.
Chair Ball?
Yes. Okay. And the conjunctive use subgrant amendment. So, and again, staff? You again.
Okay. There was a contract between the Santa Rosa Valley Water District and the county for the administration of the conjunctive use program. And initially, we were going to have the county as the lead running the contracts with the consultants that will be doing the analysis for both the hydrological analysis and the fish analysis. And we have decided that it would be more streamlined and more efficient to have those contracts run through the district, so the funds will still come from the state to the county, and then the county will then reimburse the district for the funds that were spent on those contracts. So that's what they got. It's just a little bit different method of administering the program.
Okay, reasonable to me. Okay. Pardon? I think I did. Okay,
no,
if not, okay, any public comment on it? I
don't
know.
I'll tell you. The conjunctive use project, the contract with the consulting with the county, is this strictly a general study? Or is this related to their inner time specifically?
It's a San Lorenzo Valley district wide, analysis
sure.
For all of the different systems.
Okay,
so
does it include also South Valley?
There is an aspect of it where we will be doing a preliminary study to look at feasibility of sharing water with Scott Valley.
Okay, thanks.
I'll make a motion to approve the changes to agreement between us and the county.
Okay.
Second.
Okay. Call for the vote.
Director Bruce?
Yes.
Director Smallman?
Yeah.
Chair Ball?
Yes. Okay, and finally, Tim East, pipe installation approval on Highway 9 in Brookdale. And I think we need materials for this.
We do have some handouts to provide.
WSC was contracted to do design services for this project a number of months ago. They were working diligently towards a design solution that would facilitate the district pipeline in certain position on what the Caltrans engineer were designing at the time. Last week, Caltrans contacted the district and said, oh, we've changed our mind. We're going a different direction. So the district has scrambled, and I will put these up here if anybody wants a copy of them. There are three to have them. The district and WSC scrambled to come up with a solution that would be appropriate for Caltrans' new design. And essentially where we are right now is we can move with installing a pipeline in a currently open trench. That trench is scheduled to be slurried in the next few weeks. So it's critical that we get authorization tonight to actually do this project so we can get our pipeline in. The estimated construction cost is about $66,000. There's a estimate gap of between $60,000 and $80,000. So what I'm going to ask for tonight on the construction side of things is the board authorize me to execute a change order with the contractor that's currently out there up to $80,000 so that we can get this project in. I do not expect it to be that much, but I want to make sure we have the authorization to move fast so that we don't get in Caltrans' way. That is different from the original $30,000 construction cost that we were proposing. So this is, in effect, a good thing. This is a good change for the project because we're actually going to cost us less to do what's being, because originally we were going to hang the pipeline underneath, and now we actually get to put it in a trench. Thank you, Caltrans. Just the way it works. In addition, I'm asking the board to authorize me to issue a change order for WSC for professional services in the tune of $15,000. You'll see the proposed engineering cost of $36,390. That is the original design cost plus an additional $15,000 to do the modifications and changes and construction oversight while the project is being constructed over the next few weeks. So tonight I've got two motions in front of you. You could probably do it in a single motion if you're so inclined, or you can do it in two motions. But this is a high priority item. It was asked at the last minute because Caltrans notified us at the last minute that they've changed their design parameters. It simplifies the project. It'll get the project in sooner. It'll open up Highway 9 sooner, which is the main reason why Caltrans moved in this direction. So it's actually a good deal all around, but we just had a week of scramble to get this all taken care of. So tonight I'm hoping the board will authorize me to execute a change order contract up to $80,000 and a change in the professional services contract of up to $15,000.
Okay. Any other comment? You got a...
Pretty clear?
Yep, pretty clear to me too, Bill, how do you?
The overall cost, well, the pipe was gonna be on some hangers or something on the sides, and then they just changed it into... So, the approximate cost adder for the project is gonna be 15,000 plus 460, or...
Well,
because now you have to do this.
The actual construction cost is actually going down by probably $100,000 plus.
Okay.
Because we don't have to hang the pipe anymore. We can actually install it in the existing trench.
Yeah.
The trench has already been dug. Caltrans is going to slurry it anyway, so they're just going to slurry it minus a hole that we're going to put in there.
Okay. Yeah, this is over. I'll make a motion to approve $80,000 for the construction contract. Not to exceed $80,000, and not to exceed $15,000 for the consulting services.
Okay. I'll second. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Any public comment on that? Mr. Hayes.
Brian, I was curious. Is this the project identified on the CIP list? Is the Highway 9 Brookdale pipeline?
Yes, it's actually the Highway 9 in Western. The Highway 9 in Brookdale is a smaller slip that occurred earlier in the storm season.
So which had 470,000? for both, that had $420,000 as an estimate for both of these?
Correct.
So this is coming in substantially less,
yes,
which is great.
Yes. And it's also, right, it's also
FEMA money.
It's just, well, not all, but the majority of 75% is FEMA.
Okay.
Important point. I forgot to call it out. We're going to get some of this back.
Nice.
Thank you.
Great. This is awesome.
Yes.
Okay. After no more discussion, then I'll call the vote.
Director Bruce?
Yes.
Director Smallman?
Yes.
Chair Ball?
Yes. Okay. Let's move on to the consent agenda. And I would like to pull the minutes from this because there's a single integer error, as I interpret it to be. So, otherwise, okay. Any other? Okay. Okay. Yourself, Dylan?
That's fine.
Okay. Any public comment on the consent agenda? I don't see any, so I'll bring that back. I'd like the. And any further discussion on 10B, which remains on the consent agenda? Yes. Okay, I'd like to move approval of item 11B, okay, on the consent agenda, California Special Districts Association credit card issued by Owners Club Bank.
Can we second that?
Okay. Okay, and just to be sure, any public comment on this? Okay, I don't see any. I'd like to call the vote then.
Director Smallman?
Aye.
Director Bruce?
Yes.
Chair Ball?
Yes. And then on the consent agenda item, there are the minutes. Let's see, I need to find.
11A, the minutes. So 11. I didn't.
Right. There's a mention of a vote that was mentioned as 3-0 when 4 voted in favor.
Is that with 6 sub 2 and then 4E potential lawsuit for injunction, and it was 4 voted 3-0? Is that the one you're talking about?
No.
Okay.
Hold on. I'm going to find it. No, it's on the Redwood Mountain Fair.
The Redwood Mountain Fair summary, yes equals 3. Is that
yes.
What you're talking about?
In my interpretation, that is that there were 4 yes votes with 1 absent.
That doesn't make any sense because if, okay, yes, okay, so it was Director Smallman, that's 4 of us. Director Hammer was absent. So there, if all these 4 voted yes, that should be yes equals 4.
Correct. So, this is the only thing I find wrong with the minutes. Can we make a motion to approve that with that change, or should it come back to the?
Yes, you can make that motion. I recommend it being
public. Sure. Okay. I'll make the motion. Okay, that we approve this with that one change from yes equals 3 to yes equals 4.
I'll second.
Okay. Any public comment on that? Okay, I don't see any public comment on this, so I'll bring it back to the board. Any further discussion? Can I take a vote on it?
Director Smallman?
Aye.
Director Bruce?
Yes.
Chair Boffman?
Yes. Okay, we've dealt with the items on the consent agenda. So what remains on our agenda? Three items, but district reports are first. I'd like to take public comment on district reports at this time. Would anybody like to comment?
There's a bill there for Regiment Tucker. Can anybody tell me what that's for? I mean, I can tell you what I think it's for.
Can you tell what page that is on?
No. I think it was $863.
So, and they're. But,
okay. Well, then
would you like to comment on what you think is the?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you what I think Rutland Tucker is all about. I think that Rutland Tucker is a law firm that doesn't work on anything for this district except the Charlene Deaver case. That's my belief. Over the years, the district has paid this law firm $150,000. The Deaver case was settled for $40,000. So I think there's something wrong with a law firm that would take $150,000 for a case that could be settled for $40,000. I think there's something wrong with a law firm like that. And I would recommend that the district never do business with this law firm again. Now, anybody can tell me where I'm wrong or that there's some other good reason for continuing to pay money to Rutland Tucker. I just like to hear it. There's another bill on there for Michael Collins Woman. Now, I spent most of my life in Silicon Valley, and there's a phenomenon that I've seen a few times over there where somebody comes to work, and more than a year goes by, and then you can objectively, even if you don't know this person, you can objectively say, this person did nothing for our company. And whenever I've seen this in Silicon Valley, there's always a reason, and the reason is always the same. That person is there because they're somebody's friend. That's why they're there. They're somebody's friend. They don't do any work. Or whatever work they do, it's how you read them, or just not effective or something. So that's Michael Collins Woman. You try for your trial, for appeals, try to introduce new evidence. I think we can objectively say he has failed across the board at everything. And the district has paid about $250,000. He's Brian Lee's friend. Brian Lee, when he was the district engineer for Rainbow Water District down in San Diego County, Michael Collins Woman was the counsel for LAFCO down there. Brian was the representative to LAFCO. So he's a friend of Brian Lee's. That's why Brian brought him here. It's a professional service, a no-bid professional services contract awarded to Brian Lee's friend. And he could have done a mile of pipeline for that. And I'm telling you, objectively, he's done nothing. And Brian brought him here. So remember the day that you met him and who brought him here.
Anybody else?
I would encourage the board to remember the day you met him and who brought him here. Thank you.
Any other public comment? Mr. Lee.
Again, we're wasting a lot of money in litigation. This is not the purpose of our water district. I'm paying water rates to get projects out litigated. So my question is, why are we continuing to pay this firm up in the Grass Valley? Let's cut the ties of it. Let's wrap up this terminating contract. Let's stop wasting money. I mean it. Thank you.
Any other public comment on the district report? I don't see any. I'll close that public comment on district reports. Okay, written communications. I'll note that there's two letters in here, one from Sean Wharton and Deb Lowen. Any other staff comment on the nature of the written communications? And there's five items. Any public comment on the written communication items in here? Okay, I don't see any in the board. So I'll close out item 13 on the written communication. Just giving acknowledgement. Okay, and then there's also informational material on here, five items. Any public comment on the informational items that are in the agenda? I don't see any. Any board comment on it? Any staff comment on the informational items? I don't see any. So we'll close out item number 14. And item 15 is adjournment. So we are adjourned at 9:23 p.m. Thanks for all the folks who stuck it out this long.